We will talk about role of sucrose in carrier's development. Ingestion of sucrose leads to a burst of metabolic activity in the plaque so that the pH may fall low enough to dissolve enamel before slowly returning to the resting level. The frequency with which substrate is made available to the plaque is therefore important. When sucrose is taken as a sweet drink, any surplus beyond the capacity of organisms in the plaque to metabolize it at the time is washed away. If sucrose-containing drinks are taken repeatedly at short intervals, the supply of substrate to the bacteria can be sufficiently frequently renewed to cause acid in the plaque to remain persistently at a destructive level. A similar effect may be caused by carbohydrate in sticky forms such as caramel, which clings to the teeth and is slowly dissolved, releasing substrate over a long period. In addition to acid production, providing sucrose leads to a significant increase in synthesis of extracellular polysaccharide. This prevents acid from diffusing away and being neutralized by saliva. Colonization by karyogenic bacteria, especially Streptococcus mutans, is highly dependent on the sucrose content of the diet. Sucrose is required for initial colonization, and increasingly availability increases the number of Streptococcus mutans in plaque. On the contrary, severe reduction in dietary sucrose causes S mutans, Streptococcus mutans, to decline in numbers or disappear from plaque.